I have been waiting to say this for over a year now. Today, I'm going to bring you behind the scenes of a new off-Broadway show. It is called Blindness, and I am telling you, it is unlike anything you've ever experienced.
It feels so good to be here right now.
Oh, I'm so happy you're here. I'm so happy we're open so that we could welcome you.
Yeah, it feels like a homecoming. We're going to talk about the show, but I think for so many people, you know, they're so thrilled that theater is coming back, but there are a lot of questions. And I think the top of everybody's mind would be safety precautions.
We've gone to the limit with safety precautions. The first thing is that our space has wonderful high ceilings and there's a lot of air circulation. Our seats are socially distanced in pods of two, and we sanitize the seats between every show, and we sanitize the air between every show. The headphones that you hear the story told through also go into a UV container and get totally sanitized. When a person comes into the space, they have their temperature taken, they're asked before questions, and they are ushered into their seat so that once they're here, they're in their own little pod, and they're safe and they're sound. The other beautiful thing about our space is that we have people entering on 15th Street and exiting on Union Square. So there's no gathering in the lobby, there's no way that you can't be socially distanced in this experience. I feel a great responsibility, honestly, I do. Aside from being a Jewish mother, I worry about everybody's safety and health, and I think we have done everything we can to make people feel safe.
Now we have to talk about the show, Blindness. So normally, you know, if someone's describing something, they may say, this is something like you've never seen before. I'm gonna go a step further and say, this is something like you've never seen and heard before.
Absolutely.
How do you explain this show?
The show is based on an amazing novel called Blindness that's written by Jose Saramago, who is a Nobel laureate. And the book itself is the story of this epidemic of blindness that occurred in a city. It's an unsettling story, I want to be honest. It's kind of a terrifying psychological thriller. But the beauty of it for these times, and you know, if someone would say, why this? There are many reasons, but one of them is because it's about a group of people that can get through a terrible situation and come out on the other side with hope and resilience. It is told through the magnificent, I would say hypnotic voice of Juliet Stevenson. You come in and you're given earphones that are sanitized, you put them on and the story surrounds you. There's a wonderful light and sound show that happens. The space gets dark and then it lightens and it gets dark again. So all of your senses are engaged. But what has been the most joyous part of it for me is that we have had the ability to bring 96 people back to work from our theater industry. While there isn't an actor on stage, I feel really good about that.
I've been waiting for this moment where we could start talking about the comeback story, and it's just so special that you're a part of that and you're leading the charge with this.
Thank you.